And you already know, man must know thyself, and knowledge reigns supreme over everything. Shout out to all my new subscribers, and peace to all my universal family. I'm back with another book review, The Community of Self by Dr. Naeem Akbar. Let's kick it. Like a coach, my sister a professor at this university, a doctor of philosophy. So I came from good stock. So for the most part, I know what I be talking about. But before I get started with this book review, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and check out my book review playlist. You know, go and check out what I got going on over there, man. You know, I got some cold pieces. But now, it's time for me to civilize the whole classroom. Don't be short, sweet, and with a whole lot of heat. The Community Itself by Dr. Naeem Akbar. First, this book was copywritten in 1985. So already we got some OG knowledge. You know how I like the old school authors and you know our great elders, and you know I just like how they was putting things together, that wordplay from from back in the days. 1985 is not that long ago. Shout out to the 80s babies. But book reviews, I like to pull out topics in the book that I find that are interesting and informative. You know, everybody gets different things out of books and maybe see things from a different angle or a different perspective, and I think that's what makes this art. You know what I'm saying? So let's roll The Community of Self by Dr. Naeem Akbar. Yeah, man, shout out to the great 80s babies. But let's get into it, The Community itself. You know, I always like to talk about knowledge itself, and when I did my research on just the word self and what that entails, you know, self is more than you. You know, self is can be your environment and the things that you affect personally. You know, that has something to do with the self. You know, but this one has a couple different interpretations, you know, that I like. And they talk about the motors, the drives, the senses, the ego, the conscious, you know, everything that goes in to the community of self, all the gears and the drives and everything that makes the self, you know, that makes it move in the right order. So, you know, there's even an illustration. You know, just the components of the community itself, and it's ruled by the will. You know, drive, senses, ego, memory, reason, conscience, and the will. You know, that's interesting. The self community ruled over by the will. You know, that's called peace. But then the components of the community of self ruled over by the will. And speaking of the community of self, my brother Sheikh Bilal did an Islamic prayer on the community of self on one of my old videos, you know, that I may put that prayer at the end of the video. But shout out to my brother Sheikh Bilal. When you go back and look at that illustration where he breaks down the components of the community of self, you know, he basically gives us a definition of all those components. And, you know, one of them that I found were interesting was the ego. And he states, another permanent citizen in the circle of the self community is the ego. The ego is the part of the self that speaks up for the rights of the individual. The ego's specialized function is to make sure that the individual's needs of the person's self are not being violated. Tool used by the ego is emotion. The strong feelings which well up from the inside of a person usually is the voice of the ego. The ego has the capacity to involve and affect the entire community by its emotional alarms. Everything one sees or hears is more beautiful when the ego is feeling love. Oh man, that ego. The ego is vital for the life of the community. When the ego is not adequately developed, the entire community of self fails to support itself. One serious consequence of the slavery and social oppression of African Americans was the retardation of the ego. When ego is retarded, people don't like themselves. When ego is retarded, it fails to motivate the memory and to remember. The senses, reasoning, and other members of the community fall down on their job. The ego can also be a tyrannical ruler over the community. If it seizes control of the community, the entire self is forced to work for the individual's needs only. That's the ego, man, and I never thought about that, man. That ego is powerful. Yeah, that ego is a cold, cold piece. Now, as he talks about the conscious, the community of self becomes a community of justice as the conscious begins to develop. The conscious is a very important member of the community in that it polices all components of the self. The conscious introduces a value of good or bad, right or wrong, to the senses' observation of the environment around them. So the conscious decides that. Man, I never thought about that though, right? You know, I probably had a thought about that, but I never thought about that. The conscious is powerful, you know, and I can see that being an integral part of the self. Let's talk about will and willpower. The willpower has the unique ability to pull the mind and the flesh in the direction of the truth. Yo, man, will. I bet you never thought about will and willpower like that. Shout out to my big brother, Will. Shout out to the OG. So the will, which is the divine representative within the person when working with the higher parts of the conscious, is developed by proper direction, which is the intended khalifa or ruler over the self community. When the will achieves rulership over the self grows to be the proper ruler over the earth. Man, that is cold, man. That is cold. Which is the intended khalifa or ruler of the self community. Shout out to Wiz Khalifa. I guess we find out what Wiz Khalifa means. People who control their lives don't have problems. The people who have problems are the ones who let other influences control their lives. Growth is a natural process. Stagnation is unnatural. That is real, man. For real. That's almost like when they say fresh water smells good, but stagnant water stinks. That's the same thing, man. That's a cold piece. Cold, cold piece. We have to get back into the knowledge of self. Knowing ourselves is a fundamental aspect of assuming personal power and effectiveness. And the central job which culture should perform is to teach people the knowledge of themselves. That's right, man. That's right. The impact of the slavery experience is discussed at length in another of my publications entitled Chains and Images of Psychological Slavery. On my path to knowledge of self, that was another book. I'm gonna do a book review on that. Chains and Images of Psychological Slavery. I'm gonna do a book review on that. That was another book that my brother gave to me when I was a very, very young guy, man. And that was a cold, cold piece. Chains and Images of Psychological Slavery. Matter of fact, I took that book to boot camp, to Navy boot camp. They sent that shit back home, but I remember I took that one with me. Knowledge of self is more than a catchy phrase. Let me say that again. Knowledge of self is more than just a catchy phrase. The ancient masters of Egypt taught man must know thyself. Ancient revelations and modern science agree that the real power in human capacity is based in the consciousness or self knowledge. It's real. Now this is a good book for it to be so short, and it got a lot of jewels and gems in it. Two persons with the same resources physically or mentally produce differently depending on how they view those resources. I ain't saying that's one man's trash is another man's treasure. I don't think it's in that context, but that's a good way of looking at something. You got to know how to use those resources and how you view those resources. Your perspective on those resources, you know, gonna determine the outcome. You know, that's real. Right under that, we cannot necessarily be what we are not. but we can become successfully what we are based upon our concept of what we are. I told you. That's a jewel in the gem right there, man. That's a cold piece, man. Now, I ain't gonna read the whole book to you. You go back and do the knowledge, but I'm gonna pull one or two more out. Those who use the words of correct scriptural interpretation as tool to excavate our own mental powers are discovering the power of light of understanding, the knowledge of nature, and the range of unnatural religious mentality on our thinking has equipped us to conquer and destroy such influences. Yo, man, that's something to think about. That is something to think about. And the last one I'm gonna pull out, and I think you talk about the relationship between man and woman, and this was what, in 1985, but this is going on right now today. But this was in 1985, and this is going on right now. This is about man and woman, and you know this would be the last one because of the unreal images of manliness and womanliness portrayed by the mass media. Men and women wrestle with the unattainable ideals of what they should be. But this last one is right up under that, man. This is going on right now. For the present rulers of society, this unreal image of manhood keeps the African-American male seeking to define his manhood in terms of some physical dimensions like fashions and gangster. He spelled gangster like that way back in 1985. I guess so. Skills pimping or harem of women, or as the mean bad dude. Such an image of manhood keeps the African American away from even desiring to be part of the marketplace of the world trade, production, or culture. But check this one out. The woman is desperately trying to live up to some image of the tough, liberated modern woman, which is unreal. And I'm gonna end with that one, man. This is a cold piece, The Community of Self by Dr. Naeem Akbar, distributed Heru. Yo, go check out my book review, subscribe to my channel, see, and then click on that book review playlist. I got some cold pieces on there, man. And like I said, I've been digging in the crates. I've been going back reading books, buying new books. I'm just in that zone, man. I don't know if it's the outdoor exercises, I don't know if it's the glow on my skin, or I don't know, it's just my time to really open up my mind. And I'ma just give it to the young men who always asking me about knowledge and what I be reading, even the queens out there. Just a bit of that, yo, go check them other videos out. There's some cold pieces. Come on and like and subscribe so you can vibe what you got. Just a bit of that, Heru, and everything is real. Peace.